Now that we have the closed caption importer plugin for QuickTime installed, we're able to export our project as a SCC file that we can put on our iPods, iPhones, or use for broadcasting. So when I export as a Sonic Sonorous SCC file, what's going to happen is Movie Captioner is going to go through my whole project and it's going to check each line and make sure there's only 32 characters per line, and it'll put a line break in the word space after that somewhere. And it'll make sure that there's no more than 4 lines per caption as well. It's best to not have line breaks in your project. Let Movie Captioner do it for you. It'll all be automatic. So let's go ahead and export. It's going to take 2 passes to go through and check for line length and break it up as need be. And it's going to ask you to save it. And it's going to use an SCC extension. If you have hide extension unchecked, click save. It's going to import it into QuickTime. And we're going to see our captions.
Just before lunch one day, a puppet show was put on at school. It was called Mr. Bungle Goes to Lunch. It was fun to watch.
One thing I didn't show you here is that what I needed to do when I first exported this file, my captions weren't quite synchronized with the video. And that's due to SCC format's buffering of the captions before it displays it. What I had to do was go to Shift Alt Start Times under the Edit menu, and I set all the captions to appear 1 second sooner. Now you'll have to just use your judgment on this. You'll have to export your SCC file and let it import into QuickTime and watch it and just kind of judge it, but look for it to be about a second, maybe a second and a half sooner it'll need to come up, because they're usually delayed, but you'll be able to adjust that right here in the edit menu. So that's how you add SCC captions. It's going to write a file on your, in this case on my desktop. It's the This is what the SCC file looks like. It's just a bunch of binary numbers that represent the captions and some time code. And if you're using compressor, this is the file that you would import in the compressor or your DVD program. So that's how easy it is to do SCC captions with Movie Captioner.